Richardson, a craniofacial surgeon based out of South India. We've just done a rhinoplasty for this patient. Have a look at this picture first. Most of you would agree that it seems like there's nothing wrong with her. But now let's have a look at the other picture. And you see she has a cleft effect on the left side. A lot of issues with the nose. We typically club all of this and call as a cleft nasal deformity. But cleft nasal deformity is a huge umbrella where patients can have multitude number of issues. And it's for us to determine what these issues are per case and then try and solve them. Now, look at this patient from the worm's eye view. Now, yes, the scar of the lip is not so nice, but the nose, if you see the columella per se, is bending. The tip is not in the midline. There's a little bit of an extra dip that you can see there on the dorsum. And this side is really constricted. So the cleft side alar base is constricted because of the earlier surgery that the surgeons have done. With loss of alar base tissue there. So if you look at this width, this length and this length is less. Also this is length already. Now that's a difficult problem to solve. We can easily get the dorsum fixed, we can get the tip in the midline. But it's really hard to get excess tissue on either side or on one side of the alar base. That's the frontal view. You can appreciate what I'm saying about the tip being on the left and the right. So we just finished this. We've done multiple things. I'll move on to the table. Okay. Right, so that's our nose now. That's our nose now. You can see we've moved the tip on the midline and the columella is straight. I've had to do a little bit of resection here in order to get this length as the same. I'm able to get a little bit more length on this side by freeing the cartilage from inside. So in effect, we've got extra length to match with the normal side. This, we've not been able to get too much length, so I've taken a little bit off from here. Keeping that, we've also got a dorsum in straight. We've got the tip in place. Come this side. You side a little. Yeah. So you can appreciate the dorsum. This is a lot of edema here because I've put a dorsal graft in from the remaining septum and everything. This is going to shrink and she's going to get a nice radix there. We've also done a septoplasty because she had some breathing issues. Yeah, so the take-home message for patients like these is to analyze what exactly is the problem and how we have to particularly treat that particular issue, as with any other case of rhinoplasty. Thank you.